Before the video starts, let me ask you guys a question. Have you ever been on Path of Titans, looking for a good realism server to play, but you find none? Well, look no further. I present to you Crimson Semi-Realism. Crimson is a fun server with a fair set of rules which keep the experience fun, yet also realistic. If you're interested in joining, I'll put the link to their Discord in the pinned comment below. The island of Gondor is home to many species of dinosaurs, but today we're just going to be looking at one. Megalania, the largest terrestrial lizard to ever walk the earth. This beast could grow up to 7 meters long and 10 times the size of a modern day Komodo dragon. Being able to sprint and swim at high speeds, the Megalania is a force to be reckoned with. A baby female Megalania steps out of the cave for the first time in her life. These next moments will be crucial in deciding if she survives this harsh world. Megalania is drawn by an unknown sound. A young Allosaurus has been ambushed by a Deinosuchus. All this was a little too much for the baby Megalania. She ran back to the safety of her cave. After a while, she regains her confidence and leaves the cave again. She is instantly reminded how dangerous this world is, as she sees this Argent get brought down with ease. Now that the Deinosuchus have moved off, she takes a bit of meat from the body and retreats to the safety of her cave to eat it. she encounters a young parasaur loafus. This is the first herbivore she's ever seen, and she's confused on how to act. She tries to scare off the young herbivore by making herself bigger and doing threatening roars. These things fail, and she once again resorts to running away. She stumbles across an adult Concavenator. This dinosaur is more than capable of killing her. She must tread carefully. She notices some Utah Raptors. Maybe if she plays her cards right, she can score a meal. The other Utah is unresponsive to the fact that his friend has just been murdered. After spending a while in the water, the Utah Raptor moves off. The Megalania decides it's too dangerous here, and she moves on. Before she goes anywhere, she needs to heal her wounds. After this, she decided it was time to go back to Grand Plains. She noticed a juvenile Spino, but it seems something else is also hunting this. With an Allosaurus hot on her tail, she had no choice but to run to a nearby cave. She would wait in this cave for days, but was eventually forced out by the need for water. After checking the coast was clear, she made her way towards the nearest water source. The water quality was too low. She would have to go elsewhere. She spotted a juvenile giga. This would be the perfect meal for her. A successful hunt. She filled her belly and then took a piece to go with her, as she still needed to go find water. Just as she was about to start dying of thirst, she arrived at Triad Falls. She would drink here and then move on. She returned to Grand Plains in search of food. And there it was, a baby spino. This thing was big, but she was hungry enough to take it on. She was very hungry, but she wasn't stupid. She couldn't win this fight, and she wasn't gonna die trying. A large herbivore was under attack. Maybe she could get a free meal out of this. Now that she was a bit bigger, she tried her luck at Crater again. She stumbles across a group of Therizinosaurus. This herbivore looks aggressive, but won't attack unless provoked. As there was nothing in Crater she could hunt, she decides to move on. Astruthiomimus gets a little too close and pays the price. With nighttime approaching, the Megalania found a spot to settle down and sleep. The Megalania spotted a baby Alberta. The hunt was on. It was being protected by the other herbivores. She would have to be careful. Herbivores that had been trying so hard to protect it had accidentally killed it. Demetri launched an attack. The fight was on. Covered in wounds, the Megalania had no choice other than to accept defeat. After healing up, it was time to attempt another hunt. As she was eating, she got challenged off the body by a pack of Utahs. Being very wounded, she had no choice other than to forfeit the body. A Thalassodromus emerged out of the water beside her. This would be a perfect opportunity for an ambush. she ran off to try and find a new place to hunt. She arrived at Hunter's Thicket, and it was now time to meet the locals. A large Deinosuchus came out of the water behind her. It seemed to be friendly. This baby Spino didn't seem as keen to be friends. A baby Sarko saw her sleeping and decided to attack her. This was a big mistake. The sound of a nearby adult Sarko was more than enough to scare off the Megalania. But luckily for her, she noticed the baby Sarko had come out to rest in this bush. This would be a free meal. It seems that this lake was also home to an adult Spino. This may become a problem. She found a baby Nycta Tyrannus. She took mercy on the baby. She wasn't hungry enough to justify killing it. This baby Giga was not so lucky. A baby Rex decided to steal from the body. This was a blatant show of disrespect, and the Rex would be punished. She didn't kill it, but she taught the baby a lesson that it would never forget. She tried giving the baby Spino some meat, but the adult had grown aggressive. The Megalania wasn't one to back down, and a fight broke out. Now that the Spinos had become aggressive towards her, it was time to leave. She would now return to a place very special to her. On her journey, she passed by some Nyctis. They started to hunt her. After this unprovoked attack, the Megalania had to retaliate. She had ambushed the baby, almost killing it. The Nyctis were not happy. In an attempt to fight her on the cliff edge, both of the adults had got themselves stuck. Seeing the baby in the distance, the Megalania knew exactly what to do. She chased down the baby and felt no remorse about what she was going to do. After a lovely meal, she set back out on her journey. She had arrived. She had travelled all the way to her birthplace, Young Grove, and she knew exactly where she was going to go next. As she approached the cave, she saw another Megalania.